Yes. Well, of course, I mean, you know, the most important thing about hope is it's part of the human condition. The human condition is all about trying to overcome challenges. And, you know, in a country in which, at least India, you know, our average age is now under 30, that's the most important thing that we have. We have lots of young people who want to go and improve their lives, improve the lives of their community, and in doing so, they'll improve the lives of everybody else in the country and the world. So, you know, hope is the most important thing that they share in some senses. As they're able to learn new things, have new experiences, see that the world is different and diverse, that gives them the strength to see that things could actually change. That the way history was does not have to be repeated. But for that, of course, you need an adequate education. You need to be able to work with your hands, to sort of feel with your heart, and also think critically. And you have to bring them all together. So an integrated system of education, which gives people the opportunity to become full human beings, is essential to that. Otherwise, it's hope without the capacity to do something about it. Or, you know, there is then considerable amount of cynicism because you can't implement things. And you're tied to the way life was when you're, you know, in the way that things were with your parents' life or your grandparents' life. And I think that that's no longer necessarily true. There will be some things that will be sort of continued between generations. And one hopes that the values of being able to do, you know, more with less, which is very much part of Indian culture, of being able to respect community, work together, not necessarily be very competitive, and respect other people for who they are and what they are. Those are sort of values that you'd want to go from generation to generation. But other things are not written in stone. You can change them. And if you can change them, then there's tremendous hope that things can be quite different. And if we share experiences from across the world, then it's so much easier. Because by and large, most things have been done before. Or if they're not done before, they're happening at the current point of time somewhere in the world. The question is to figure out where it is and be able to share that experience. And then, of course, one would translate that into one's context. Because eventually when change happens, it happens in a context. And, you know, if you're able to take an experience from, let's say, Denmark or from Argentina or from China or Thailand or the United States and apply it into your own circumstance, in your own community, that's a fantastic thing. And today, with the technologies we have and the opportunity to learn, I think that's certainly possible.